Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.6 Beta 2. This is currently available to developers, and hopefully by the time you're watching this video, it will be out to public beta testers as well. This came in at 523.5 megabytes, that's on my 13 Pro Max, and it was between 400 and 600 megabytes on all the devices you see here. Now along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 15.6 Beta 2, watchOS 8.7 Beta 2, tvOS 15.6 Beta 2, and macOS 12.5 Beta 2. All of those are available to developers now. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then General, then About. As you can see, the build number is 19G5037D. With the D at the end, that means we could be a couple builds away from the final release. Usually we'll get closer to the letter A, and then they'll release it to the public. So it could be a little ways off now. Now this particular update does not have any huge changes in it, and there is no modem update in this update, so it has the same modem firmware build, at least on the 13 Pro Max, that I did with Beta 1 at 1.60.00. However, with that particular modem update, that was a rollback from what we had with the previous update with 15.5, so it's almost like they rolled it back with 15.5 to Beta 1, and so far it's actually been pretty good. Between switching to 5G, 5G UC, 4G, the modem is behaving at least better for me than it was on 15.5. However, they haven't updated it at all for Beta 2. Now, as far as the major changes and features in this update, well, most of them are in the code. Now, this past week, Apple did introduce new Pride watch faces, and those watch faces are called Pride threads, and there's basically a light mode and a dark mode version of those. They released this alongside watch bands that you can get at the Apple Store now or order online, and within Beta 2, we know that the code name of this watch face is actually called Lilypad. So that's just something that was within the code, and thanks again to my friend Steve Mosier for helping me out with that. Now within the Home app, there's actually mentions of Matter accessories. So that's a new standard that we're going to see across Apple and Google and others, and we should see support for that built in even more in the future. So we do have some support for them. It's a little bit limited and could be a bit buggy with 15.5. There's additional mentions of that in this code. There's also mentions in the code when it comes to shortcuts. So if we go into shortcuts, maybe you're getting contents of a web page. When you set this and maybe you go to run it, it's going to ask you to allow the shortcut to access apple.com or whatever you're setting this up as. And there's a new message that you could see that says allow whatever you're looking at to access while loading web content on. So it's loading web content on something else. You could have a new message here, but nothing huge as far as changes within this update. Those are mostly just code changes, and I think Apple's really keeping quiet on what's going to be with iOS 16. Now, also this past week, Apple introduced Apple Digital ID in Maryland. So if we go into the wallet, if you tap on the plus button, you'll see driver's license or state ID. I mentioned this in another video, but now we have Arizona and Maryland. So if you live in the state of Maryland, you can now add your driver's license if you want to use it here. It's completely optional, but your state has to agree to this, or country. So where you live has to work with Apple to get this implemented. So that's why we only see it for two different states right now. So not all states may support this. Some might. Some might not, but they do have to support it and work with Apple to get that done. WWDC 2022 is just under a week away when we'll see iOS 16 and more, and Apple today updated their website with more information. You can see it says watch June 6th at 10 a.m. Pacific time, view at apple.com or on the Apple TV app. You can also watch it on YouTube where they have a reminder, where you can see on their channel where they have a reminder for when it's actually going live. Here it's 1 p.m. They made this live today, and you can set a reminder for it. So this will adjust based on where you live, 1 p.m. for me, but wherever you live, it will adjust for that. Also, if you're a developer, they've added the option for digital lounge signups. So you can register to go into a digital lounge, and you'll see it says join Apple engineers and designers throughout the week as they host text-based Q&As, session watch parties with presenters, community icebreakers, and more. And then it gives eligibility requirements and registration information. So those went live today. So if you're a developer, be sure to check these out if you haven't already. Now, in a moment, we'll talk about known issues and resolved issues. But first, I want to talk about iOS 15.5.1, as many of you have been asking, where is that? Last week, Apple released tvOS 15.5.1 and HomePod OS 15.5.1, and those were to address some issues that we had with audio stopping playing when you're actually using those devices. So maybe you have your HomePod and all of a sudden the music would just stop playing. That resolved those issues. We did not see an iOS release, and many of us thought we'd have it last week. We could see it this coming week, so it's possible we'll see it very, very soon, maybe as soon as tomorrow, or maybe they'll just skip it all together and wait for 15.6. Apple has not said publicly, but I'm surprised we haven't seen that already with bug fixes and security updates. Of course, at this point, like I said, we're not seeing a whole lot of changes with iOS 15.6, and that's probably because the big changes are coming with iOS 16 Beta 1 on June 6th. We expect Beta 1 to be released on June 6th, with the public betas to come out in July. So probably around beta 2 and beta 3. So typically that's what Apple does. We'll see iOS 16 beta 1 with all of its features here. And that's probably why we're not seeing much with 15.6. Typically Apple will continue to have 15 betas and iOS 16 betas until a final release in September. That's typically what they do every single year. So they could change that up this year or continue to do that. But last week or a week or so ago, Apple stopped signing 15.4.1, meaning we can only downgrade to 15.5, and it's likely that we'll see a 15.5.1 very soon. Now, as far as security updates, at this point, I wouldn't really expect us to know anything about that, but typically Apple will add security updates and let us know about them when they release this to the public. So there'll definitely be some security updates in it. There could be a few, there could be many, but we won't know until a public release. Now, as far as known and resolved issues, Apple has only mentioned one, at least within the notes. That doesn't mean they didn't fix other things, but if we go into the feedback app, you can see here where the release notes only mention one known issue. This is the same issue we had with beta 1. It says Xcode 13.4 is unable to prepare iOS 15.6 beta devices for development. The workaround is to use Xcode 13.3.1. So not a whole lot mentioned here, and they haven't mentioned anything about that storage bug. Now, storage, I wanted to clarify something and maybe help out a little bit. If you go into your settings and go to iPhone storage, scroll all the way to the bottom, you'll see system data. Once system data loads, we'll give it just a moment. This could be taking up a huge amount of storage. Now, it's not meant to be checked all of the time. Typically, you would check this if maybe you're running out of storage just to see what was using it. But it's at the bottom for a reason, as this can vary greatly. So I'll give it a moment to load, and then I'll tell you how maybe you can clear this out a little bit better. It's finally loaded, and as you can see on the iPhone 11 on the left, we have 5.55 gigabytes of usage. That's completely fine. It varies, like I said. And then on the right, we have 9.11 gigabytes of usage. Now, if this is using a huge amount to the point where maybe you're running out of storage, you can clear this. And this is thanks to a suggestion by TechBush Pro. He messaged me and said, by plugging this into iTunes or to Finder on a Mac, and then just syncing your iPod or iPhone, it seems to clear this right up. So you can clear the cache on your phone in Safari, but also plugging that in, if it's using a ton of data, that can help alleviate some of that problem. I haven't tried it myself, but it has seemed to work from what I can find online. Now, as far as overheating or anything else like that, the phone does not seem to be getting very warm with beta 2. I know some people with beta 1 said they had it, but it was much better with beta 1 as compared to 15.5. So the phone seems to be staying nice and cool. It will warm up a little bit when charging. That's completely normal, but the phone should manage that as it has temperature sensors and a temperature sensor in the MagSafe adapter to keep it within range. So it should take care of that itself, but if it's getting extremely hot, it's a beta, be sure to report that in feedback. Now, as far as if you should install iOS 15.6 beta 2, well, at this point, it depends on whether or not you want to try out 15.6 or you want to try out iOS 16 in just a week from now. iOS 16 beta 1 is expected on June 6th, like I said, and if you're wanting to try that and you're a developer, and you know what you're getting into, as those tend to be very buggy to begin with, then you could hold off. However, if you're developing an app, or maybe you're just on 15.6 beta 1, then I would definitely install it. Otherwise, I would probably hold off at this point. As far as battery life has been very hit or miss on beta one for me, and it really depends what you use. And if we go to the last 10 days here, take a look at yesterday. I had 2 hours and 16 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 40 minutes of screen off time, and used about 40% of my battery. My battery has not been great, and the same is true on the iPad. The iPad battery on iPadOS 15.6 hasn't been great or come back to what it was with early versions of iOS 15. My battery health is also still at 100%. I charge it every single night on a wireless charger and in my car wirelessly when I'm driving, but I don't use a case, so that does help with heat quite a bit. As far as performance, I did run benchmarks, but it does seem to be nice and fast. And some of you have mentioned that you wanted me to show different games and things to show performance. So as far as going into music and just letting that load for the first time, on the iPhone 8 Plus, it's nice and smooth. If we go into maybe I have Minecraft here, and I've also loaded some other games that we could take a look at later, maybe Apex Legends in future videos, or if there's something else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. But you'll see Minecraft here. I had it loaded. We'll give it just a moment to see what it's like. And if we hit resume, frame rates and everything seem to be nice and smooth. So if you were having issues with it being stuttery or being slow, it looks like beta 2 is nice and fast and smooth on any device that I've used it on so far. So nice and fast, nice 60 hertz refresh rate. It doesn't seem to be a problem whatsoever. As far as the benchmarks are concerned, I did run them on my 13 Pro Max, just to give you an idea. And if we go into Geekbench 5, you can see my single core is 1,739, multi-core is 4,708. If we take a look at the history, we'll go back here. Last time I ran this, it was 1,728 and 4,705. So it's actually a little bit better this time around, just by a little bit, but it seems to be performing very much the same. But so far I haven't had any lockups like I did on beta one. So I had some touch lockups and it's been good so far, but it's only been a couple of hours. Now, as far as when iOS 15.6 beta 3 will release, well, most of us are expecting iOS 16 beta 1 on June 6th. Now it's possible we could have 15.6 beta 3 next week, but I think it's more likely that it will be again another week after that, usually on a bi-weekly schedule from beta 1 to 2 to 3. That's not always the case. They could change that up, but that seems to be the most likely. And that's where we'll probably see more features that also are available with iOS 16 as well. So that's really what I'm expecting as far as that. So maybe in a couple of weeks, it's possible next week with beta 3, but I think it's more likely a week after that. And so that's everything with iOS 15.6 beta 2. Now, of course, if I find anything else, I'll let you know a little bit later in the week. And if you found anything, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.